Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's take a look at using the new MiniPlayer and movie windows in iTunes 11. So there's a whole new MiniPlayer window in iTunes 11 and it has lots of new functionality. It's worth taking a look at. There's several different ways to bring it up. One is you can hit this little button right here, which is the same as going to Window and switch to MiniPlayer. And that closes the main iTunes interface and just shows you the MiniPlayer. But you can also bring up the MiniPlayer without closing iTunes, the whole big window here, which we're going to do right now just by going to Window MiniPlayer. You can see there's a keyboard shortcut there as well. And you get this little MiniPlayer window here that you can move around and it'll show you the name of the current song and group that's playing, or in this case paused. And if you roll over it, you have controls for a play and fast forward and such. You also have your AirPlay controls. You have this very powerful button here which brings up your entire playlist, your up next list. You can switch to search right there, so you can actually search for another song and start it playing without having to leave the MiniPlayer window at all. And you can actually bring up extra functionality here by clicking on this button. So there's a ton of stuff you can do in this MiniPlayer window without having to use the entire iTunes window. So it's quite handy just for that. In addition, you can close it by hitting this X button here, or you could switch back to the main iTunes window by hitting this button. That's handy if you actually have closed the entire iTunes window to bring up the MiniPlayer. You can switch back and forth between them hitting that button there and then this button here just to go back and forth between them. So there's a lot you can do and you can move this around. Now in addition to the MiniPlayer window, there's another window you may not know about. It's called the Movie window, but it also can be considered an Artwork window as well. You can bring it up from the MiniPlayer by clicking on the artwork here, but you can also bring it up in the main iTunes interface by clicking on the artwork there. Either one of those works. You click on it and you can see here I get this other window that shows the artwork. Now this is very interesting because a lot of people have been complaining that in iTunes 11 you no longer have artwork at the bottom left hand corner like you could bring up with previous versions of iTunes. A lot of people like that. But you still do have this artwork window. And with this artwork window you can actually put it down the bottom left if you really want. You can move it anywhere on the screen, which makes it better than that window that was there before. And not only just show you the album artwork, but also has playback controls right on it. So it's kind of a mini player in its own right. You can have both or just have one of the two, and you have artwork in either one. Now you've got even more power with these if you use this simple preference in iTunes preferences. If you go to the advanced preferences, at the bottom you can see you've got keep MiniPlayer on top and keep movie window on top. That's the only way we know this is called the movie window, not the artwork window, is because of this preference here. And once you do that, the interesting thing is that it not only stays on top of iTunes but also other apps as well. So for instance, here I just going to open a file in TextEdit, and you can see that these two windows remain on top of those. So you'll never lose them if you use that functionality there to keep these both on top. So it's quite handy for that, and it really then makes this artwork window much more useful than anything we had before with just having the artwork inside of iTunes, because you can put it in your bottom left hand corner of your screen if you want, or anywhere in your screen, and then see the artwork and control the playback from there. So if you like using iTunes to play back your music, try the MiniPlayer window and the movie slash artwork window. And one thing to do to really get the most out of these is try forcing yourself to use them. It's kind of like learning a foreign language by immersing yourself in that language. If you try to actually just use iTunes with the MiniPlayer window and this movie window, and you do that for a few hours, you'll find that you can do most things that you'd want to do for music playback with just these two little windows. And then you'll start to use them regularly. So I hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.